this week on Erie Extreme.
We got an extreme Facebook challenge for you.
Jeff from Wesleyville put in a request for you to catch 5 crappies. You think you can do that? But there's a catch. You have to catch
5 crappies from 5 different lakes in 6 hours.
That's your extreme Facebook challenge. Good luck.
He'll never be able to do
it's
that.
The Erie Extreme Challenge.
What do you think?
Why?
Erie Extreme is made possible with the help of these fine local businesses. Fast Signs, Marquette Savings Bank, Sunburst Electronics, Country Fair, Sitco, We Create, Pennsylvania Fish and Boat Commission, Zodiac Diner, Presque Isle Angler Bait and Tackle, The Avonia Tavern, Palmero Toyota, and World of Music.
I'm Dave Lefebvre, and I'm getting out of my comfort zone. Exploring extreme places and culture, discovering extreme people, while encountering extreme weather. Where do I plan to do all this? Well, in my own backyard, of course. This is not your typical fishing show. It's unscripted, outside the box, and 100% real. This is Erie Extreme.
I'm getting too old for this. You know, we knew the call was coming from Nate at We Create.
Dave.
We got an extreme Facebook challenge for you.
Jeff from Wesleyville put in a request for you to catch 5 crappies. You think you can do that? But there's a catch. You have to catch
5 crappies from 5 different lakes in 6 hours.
That's your extreme Facebook challenge. Good luck.
I'll never be able to do that.
It's the Erie Extreme Challenge, and Jeff, I accept that challenge.
Better eat some more hot dogs.
Are there even 5 lakes around here?
Edinburgh.
You said Conneaut, Wilhelm, then Edinburgh. Then you can hit back.
Edinburgh. What do you think?
Why? Well, you'll be all day. Traveling's gonna take up your time.
So that's about roughly 65 miles. So that's before we even start. Back to Conneaut, it's gonna be 78 miles total. Back to 79, up to Edinburgh. And then to Waterford, to LaBeouf, 115 miles. That's 140 miles, and that would be 5 lakes. If we left Waterford, it's supposed to be windy tomorrow, so I don't really like the Presque Isle Bay option. I'm thinking more like Findlay. I'd like to go to Chautauqua, but it's too far out of the way. So we're going to be close to 150 miles. Okay, that's the plan right there, I think. Truthfully, I don't know if we can actually do this. I mean, I'm not confident at all. With a 6-hour time limit. I feel like I should be going down to Pymatuming first because I think I can catch one there quick. But we're gonna go to Conneaut Lake first. So I haven't fished Conneaut in a decade. Matter of fact, I have never crappie fished here.
We figured out exactly what lakes we wanted to hit, but when we got into Conneaut Lake, I saw Conneaut and I thought, you know what? We're gonna start there, see if we can catch one quick. If we can't, we're gonna head to Pymatuming. If we do, we're going to start working our way back toward Erie. We're going to hit Edinburgh Lake after this, LaBeouf. The plan is to go to Findlay Lake, which is just barely into New York, and then straight to Presque Isle Bay to end the day. We're going to be putting some miles on the truck today, on the tires. Got to looking at the tires, oh my gosh. I mean, they are bald. I'm actually going to just tie a jig head on this one for now. That gives me some flexibility. I mean, every lake we hit is going to be completely different. LaBeouf, I haven't fished in 5 or 6 years. Edinburgh, 5 or 6 years. You got to drive, Dan? Extreme Facebook Challenge starts now. We've got probably a half hour drive between each one.
Whoa!
So for the day, you know, I grabbed Danny. Danny happened to be off work today. He's gonna help me unstrap the boat and make sure we're, you know, going to the right lake at the right time. And, you know, just some support here. So he's helping cut my time in half here. Oh, man, Should have looked at the water before we rigged. Look at this, it's crystal clear.
This is fun not having a single clue where to go. I have never, ever caught a crappie on this lake. I got an idea though. The way I'm looking at it, we can't spend more than 20, 30 minutes on a lake. This could be a major, major mistake. Major mistake. I'm going up in here. It's a little protected bay. This is where a crappie, there should be one here. There used to be a lily pad here. I don't know if it's still here. Okay, golly, crystal clear. Dumb. Holy crap. I have never seen this lake this clear. I started in a shallow area where there is usually some lily pads and the lily pads weren't up yet. I can't imagine them being this shallow when it's this clear. Got to keep an eye on the time. I say we give this like maybe 5 or 10 minutes. It's going to be like a mad rush to the truck if we catch a crappie, I can tell you that. I'm trying to think where we can go next. Like, any suggestions, Dan? No. I mean how to catch a crappie on this lake. Maybe a deep dock. You know, the good thing about fishing a dock is, you know, we can skip up under there and it's clear. There might be one. What about pontoons? There's some pontoon boats over there. The clarity is all that's killing us. I really feel like you could get around these bushes and catch one if it was muddier. How long have we been here? We should have went to Pontoon. I'm attuning. I got a feeling with it being this clear, I'm gonna go out and look for grass out deep. Yeah, we're not in a hurry or anything. What's the deal, man? Never had this happen before. I'm gonna go check a deep pump that usually has some grass on it real quick. I don't see any grass here. Dang it, we might have screwed up on the very first lake. Dumb. At some point we gotta give up on this lake. I think I gotta hit those docks right there. I'm gonna freeze to death. Strike two, as our crappie counter's at zero still. That was pretty good. If there was one under there, he would have got it. I don't even know if it's worth even trying any more of these. Abort lake. Freezing. I said, you know, let's just get the heck out of here. Head down to Pontoon where we should have started in the first place. Oh, I just missed one. Crazy, I dropped that down there and got a bite right away. Man, even if we catch one, we're still burnt way too much time. That means we got to catch them super quick at the next lakes. I don't like it. Big time mistake. What do you think about going to Pontoon? Man, I can catch one quick there, I think. If we don't catch one here, we have to go to Finley. Wait, if we don't catch one here, we don't have five more lakes. I just wanted to try one more place.
Looks like starting on Pontiac could have been a big mistake. We wasted an hour already. Not a care in the world. Like a little baby. So cute and precious. I'm dropping something down right here.
Okay, so we stopped in an area, kind of, again, on a grass line.
Oh, come on, be crappies. Got one. Dude, it's a crappie too.
And I got a bite right away, and you know what? It felt like a big crappie.
I believe it is.
Your website is often the first impression a customer has of your business. So even though your operation runs like this, this is what they really see. What you need is an exceptional web presence that gets results. Allow the fun and creative team of WeCreate and Erie PA to brainstorm innovative ways to grow your business online and offline. Take it from our clients who are now getting the results they deserve. Visit WeCreate.com today to find out how you can transform your website from this to this.
As a small business owner, I have a lot on my plate. That's why I work with Fast Signs for all my marketing needs. The crew at Fast Signs takes extra measures to make sure my signs are a perfect fit. Every project is custom tailored for my business. I never dreamed that there were this many ways that fast signs can help my business. They really are more than fast, more than signs.
It felt like a big crappie.
I believe it is. No, it's a perch. Come on. Boy, that's a nice one. Oh man, I got excited on that. There's a Conneaut Lake perch. That's a big one, but it ain't gonna do us any good in the challenge.
It ended up being a big perch, and once I caught that one, I made a few more casts, no more bites, and we hauled butt back to the truck.
So when I saw how clear it was when we put the boat in the water, one more cast. We should have put it right back on the trailer. I know I'm cold. I can't wait to get my coat on. Last cast. Did I already say that? It's raining right there.
Okay, we're gone.
I think we're gonna go to Pymatuming.
You know, going to Conneaut first was a big mistake. We literally left there completely empty-handed.
Took an hour in the rain. I'm already frozen. That was a thing to get wet. Okay, run, Dan. Hey, listen. This is gonna sound stupid. I don't have a whole lot of time to talk, but I need to catch a crappie at Conneaut. I actually fished for a couple hours and didn't catch one. You got a place where you think I can pull up and catch one real quick?
You know, when we were putting the boat on the trailer at Conneaut, I knew we had to come back through there on our way back from Pymatuming. So I just decided to call one of my buddies.
Go ahead, Dan.
So on the drive down to Pymatuming, you know, we had some thinking to do.
All right, I might give that a try. Okay, thanks, buddy. That might actually be worth coming back here, really. If we catch one at Pymatuming, we might just run right back here. We gotta pass it anyway. Try that spot he told me about. Maybe we'll get lucky and catch it. You guys can leave your trucks here. We'll go together. Coming right back through here. Take a look at that. Pouring down rain where we just were in the boat. Okay, strike one. Headed to Pymatuming.
What's the speed limit here, 80?
Oh, it's probably 45.
Okay. Okay, so if I put in right there and just head toward the restaurant where we always used to eat. Alrighty, I'll let you know how it goes.
Well, we got lots of time to think about it. I'm getting so mad about this driving 30 miles an hour in a 55.
I have a lot of faith in what we're doing right now, man. If this doesn't work, we lose the challenge. I mean, we lose. We're down to 4 hours with no crappies.
Right.
Holy cow. Okay, this is the boat ramp right here.
So we pull into the campground there at Jamestown.
Oh, no. Oh my gosh, if anything can kill you.
We finally got a look at Pymatuming.
Can't even fish the spot. The spot's right out there in the middle.
Is there a launch on the other side?
There's no crappies on the other side.
It looked like the ocean. The wind was blowing right into the boat ramp.
We're gonna just try something different. It's not good, man.
There was no way that we could get the boat to where I wanted to fish.
It's not good. Now it's not a guarantee like it was.
I got a hold of Jimmy.
Hey, can we catch a crappie inside Jamestown Bay by the rocks?
And he's like, I don't know what to tell you. He said, they're not biting.
Where can we catch one? There's 10-foot waves on the brush pile.
All the way in the back?
Yo, camera, need camera. Remember, we're in a big hurry, for real. This is not acting, this is Campground Bay. You ready, Dan? Shut the door, door open.
What are we gonna do? I mean, we're already there. We're just gonna put the boat in, fly over to the old beaver hut, see if we can get a bite.
Nasty. One of the things you love and one of the things you hate about fishing, because you never know what Mother Nature is going to throw at you. We got a challenge. We have to do it today. And I got a spot right over there, a quarter of a mile, where we can catch probably 50 to 100 crappies. And all we need to do is go catch one, hurry up, get on the trailer, and go back to the next lake. But we can't get there. Something wrong?
Yeah, something broke. Something that ain't right. It wasn't like this in the car.
You just can't push buttons, Terry. Jeez. You gotta quit pushing buttons, man. You push zebra.
What is zebra?
I don't know, but you pushed it. Okay.
It's the one that makes it look zebra.
Yeah. We We're in a tough spot now. A guaranteed quick crappie.
I have confidence in
you. Is history. So I called a buddy that fishes here all the time, and he said, we probably cannot catch one in Campground Bay, which is where we're at. But we have no choice because the wind is blowing too hard and we'll die if we go out there. All we need is one quick bite. We're 2 minutes from the boat ramp. Yes, that's a crappie. It's a crappie. Yes. Okay, we're gone. We're gone. We're gone. Dude, that was quick, okay? Two casts. Come on, we're out of here. That makes up for our faux pas at Kania. Threw that chartreuse tube in there, caught one right off the bat. So I was really pumped up about that after a bad start at Kania. We hurried up, idled back, put the boat on the trailer, heading back to Kania. Come back here, Dan, so we don't sink. That's pretty good. That took, like, that's gonna take a grand total of like 12 minutes from the time we put the boat in the water to catch a fish, get back on the trailer. Man, is it bad out here? He's saving me some time, that's for sure. Run, Danny, run! Ah! That could have been a train wreck. This wind could have killed us. We really got lucky. 10 minutes.
At Palmero Toyota, we employ people you know and who care about you.
It's not what I expected coming into a dealership, working in a small town, hometown garage. It's kind of the same feel. A lot more people, but they're just like a family, really. The technicians, they're great. I've worked with a lot of very good technicians. I was a technician. These guys are top notch.
Palmero Toyota, located on the Conneaut Lake Road in Meadville, or 24/7 at palmerotoyota.net.
This is it, your hometown and ours. The places you depend on, people you trust, family, friends, neighbors, our hopes and our dreams. Home. This is the story we write every day, yours and ours, and it will be what we want it to be. We're here to empower people just like you. Because when it's your hometown, it matters more. Marquette Savings Bank, the hometown bank.
I'm Trinity, and you're watching Erie Extreme.
Do you know who Dave LaFebra is?
Do what? Well, the, not exactly.
Well?
Kinda, yeah.
Famous? Yes.
I do not know who Dave
LaFebra.
I have no idea.
Maybe the most famous is the Brig Niagara.
Check one. Check. Check.
Commodore Perry.
Famous? I mean,
The Jetson House of the town of Waterford.
George Washington.
Lake Erie.
I got my master's degree from Edinburgh University.
So. There's the university I would say that a lot of people would know about.
Peek and peek.
I'm Todd, and you're watching Erie Extreme.
It's just a special place. Lived here for over 40 years.
My real technical home is back in Lawrence Park, Erie, but I come down here a lot because my grandparents live in the area.
Just love the area.
I like the rich history. Also, the great schools around here are very good. They're better than most areas around here.
Fell in love with my beautiful wife, and we decided to stay here, raise a family.
My name is Judy Noble.
I grew up right here in Waterford.
We're here on Main Street in Finley Lake. I have a gift shop called Wonderment.
Welcome to the Eagle Hotel in the historic Waterford, Pennsylvania. My daughter was born, and I just bought a house over in Corey. That's kind of where I ended up.
That was excellent. Thank you so much. You don't know who he is?
No.
most people don't.
Attention all viewers! Do you have an extreme catch worthy of my bragging board? I'm Bob the Parrot. Submit your favorite fish photo for a chance to get posted on my bragging board. Ah! You can also win some awesome prizes. Subscribe to the Erie Extreme YouTube channel for even more chances to win. And remember what I always say, save a worm for a bird. Why do I say that again? Ow! Ow!
All right, I'm being a baby. See, you okay where he's at? You can't see me, right?
Nope.
It's like you're not even there.
Not right now.
No.
10 minutes we were here. Okay. Okay, we're ready. We definitely made up for lost time at Conneaut. In and out, 12 minutes. And we had a curveball thrown at us. That is,
this whole challenge, you know, was about strategy. So while we're driving, we have a lot of time to talk.
Still got four lakes to go, four crappies left. We got one real quick. Pima Tuming, struck out at Conneaut, going back to Conneaut, putting in, going to a little spot a buddy of mine told me about, real close to the boat ramp. Try to get number two. See that? That right there is costing us time. And I mean serious.
Same old story. We got behind a guy in a big old pontoon boat.
Make sure you come to a complete stop and look all seven ways before you proceed. This is the kind of thing that happens when you're in a hurry. Can you believe this? Seriously. Pouring down rain now. Oh, wow. See that? The weather. Seriously not cooperating with us. You gotta always expect the worst. We'll just drop you. You drop me in the lake and we'll just take off. So we can go faster. Leave Danny on the dock real quick. Just run, try it real quick. If it don't work, we're out of here. Okay. Actually, let me back there. What am I thinking? Okay, we're not gonna waste any time here. We'll be back, Danny boy.
I had my fingers crossed. I was counting on my buddy's spot.
The good thing is we're not gonna kill any time. We're driving right by Conneaut anyway. And the spot is like literally right here. I just gotta find the weed line. Now, I'm gonna try this drop shot. Actually, no, I'm gonna drop this tube down there. Totally opposite from Pima Tuming. We caught that one in 2 feet of water in mud on a beaver hut. And this, now we're fishing 20 feet of water, crystal clear, and we're only 10 miles away. It's like a totally different world. If we don't catch one on the first pass, we're out of here. Just as quick as we got here. I might need to use that drop shot. It's got a bigger weight on it. Jeez, it's so daggone windy today. Dropped that little tube down there, drifted, I don't know, just a few yards and hooked up immediately. I mean, I'm marking them here, but it's the same. It looks exactly the same as it did where we were. There's one. That's a perch. No, it's not. It's a crappie. It's a crappie. Dude, oh my gosh,
it was another small fish, but it was a crappie.
Look how white
it was. Number two, we only had three more to go, and I felt like we kind of salvaged the day.
Thank you, buddy. Not gonna lie, we got a little help on this one. Dropped it down there, caught one quick. I think we caught that one quicker than at Pima Tuming. Man, that is a bonus. It felt like the bites I was getting earlier here. Those were probably crappies too. That's a miracle. I can't even believe it. Are we back on schedule a little bit now? I don't know if Danny even knows we caught that one. We're back on track. We caught one in, what, how long were we gone? 4 minutes? Yeah, we did. It was a baby, but it was a crappie. It felt like, dude, it felt just like the bites I was getting earlier when we were here. It felt like a perch. I even said it was a perch when it bit. Let's boogie. Now we gotta think where we're going.
One of the longest drives of the day was when we left Conneaut for the second time and headed off to Edinburgh.
Terry, you guys are gonna get your trucks now, right?
Come on. Thank you, Conneaut Lake. Why not? School buses.
Everything that could go wrong was definitely going wrong.
Unreal. I mean, you have got to be kidding.
We're off to the third lake. This should be a pretty quick one. We're getting later in the day now. It's almost 2 o'clock, but if we can get one quick at Edinburgh, I think we can pull it off. If it takes us too long at Edinburgh, we're done.
Wind is just getting stronger and stronger. Now it's afternoon, sun's warming up the water. Man, it should be a perfect scenario.
Now that the sun's out, I finally got my coat. Nasty day. Wind is howling. The later it gets in the day. Of course, we got behind the slowest traffic. We got school buses, red lights, work zones.
We finally got to Edinburgh, and I was so fired up.
Come on, Dan. Here he comes.
This is a place that I've fished all my life, and I know what the crappie should be doing at Edinburgh right now.
Hurry up. Lake number 3, Edinburgh, one of my favorite lakes. That's our first look at the water. Of course, it's getting windier.
The water looked pretty good, but the boat, just wasn't running good. We had all three guys in the boat. We were fighting a real heavy wind.
We're gonna run back into the fingers, and hopefully this doesn't take very long. Not as rough as Edinburgh can get. Hey, Dan, can you tie that tube on that rod that I broke off? Oh my gosh, this is way more along than I thought. You know what? I'm not feeling as confident as I did. No, I'm not real happy about this, what I'm seeing.
You know, this place is just a couple miles from my house. I think there's probably one a couple miles from just about everybody's house. Just a good place to stop and get everything I need and get it quick, which in this case is gonna be gas, a drink, and a sub. You know, that's one thing I like about Country Fair. I tend to forget a lot, and there's 4 of them between my house and the boat ramp.
Check out the Erie Extreme YouTube channel, where you can get a more in-depth look, view raw uncut episodes, fun segments, a loud obnoxious parrot, and more. When you subscribe, you will be eligible to win extreme prizes, plus the chance to win a trip to fish with Dave on world-famous Lake Erie. And remember, like our good friend Bob the Parrot always says, save a worm for a bird.
Why do I say that again?
Next week on Erie Extreme.
Where are we at, the third lake? Why is it gonna be a curveball at every single place?
Where are you going? I couldn't believe it, I was so mad.
What happened next
totally blew my mind.
We're not gonna find it, Dan. I can't
see it.
Did you see that?
You see the bobber?
I broke him off. Oh my gosh, what am I, a little kid? Got him. You kidding me? Look at that. Dan, look at the clock up here. Come up here.
There's nothing left in my tube.
I'll never forget today, ever.